the color of my love. Might
as well face it. Emotions ran high last week. To never, ever stop. The performances were heartfelt. And left me blind. Our final six were revealed. But the road to six was a rocky one.
The individual that I feel should remain in the competition is Odell.
After a shocking two-person elimination, our final six wasted no time getting down to work and gaining valuable insights from one of local music's finest with a meeting at Scape.
Don't you worry about a thing.
So much better because you project better.
Really?
Really? If you have to scream, scream. Okay. You have to go, right, ghost. Okay. Sing, go for it. Keep the energy level up here.
Okay.
Don't go back down.
Okay.
Study people's styles and develop your own. When he's on stage, he has to throw away that shyness and then perform. I noticed when you were singing, you were swallowing your words a little bit. You have to be clear.
Real advice that can only come from a real icon.
Would you consider making singing a career?
Yes.
Have you thought seriously about it? Singers, musicians will always be exploited. You have to be really strong to survive. I'm not trying to scare you off the industry, but the industry is a mean one.
Welcome to another episode of The Final One. This week is part two to our sustainability theme, and our final six had the pleasure of working with one of Singapore's rock legends, Zul Sultan. If there's anyone who knows about sustainability, it's Zul Sultan. And with 39 years of his music career still going strong, Zul's the man. Well, Odell, what was it like meeting one of our local music icons?
Yeah, it was a really good experience, and I think it's a great opportunity to meet him.
Aza, what's one thing, one advice from Zul, you know, that stuck with you the most?
I can't say it here, but he asked me to squeeze... squeeze my butt cheek.
Okay. Is that for the high note?
Yeah, for the high note, yeah. Because okay, so it kind of went off.
Has
yeah.
it worked?
It really helped me out a lot, yeah.
All right, thank you, Aza. Moving on with the show, if you guys notice, there's only two judges on the panel tonight. And that's because our judge Jacqueline has gone away on maternity leave to have a baby. So all of us at The Final One would like to wish her a very big, big congratulations. Let's give her a round of applause. You might be wondering how we're going to be moving on. Well, we are going to see the return of another local music icon who's not a stranger to The Final One. In the last season, I had a chance and privilege to work with her as one of my mentors. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome none other than the beautiful Kit Chan. Make some noise! All right, let's give Kit another round of applause.
Tonight's theme is on sustainability. To my right is an artist who exemplifies the very meaning of it with finesse. My good friend, Kit Chan.
Wow. Thank you, Ken.
I'm sure your presence here today is going to inspire our contestants to do better.
Well, I'm really looking forward to watching you guys. And the only thing I can say is please just don't be nervous, because that kind of just kills all the fun, and it also will not allow you to do your best. So try to be relaxed and just show us what you're capable of, and we'll enjoy it.
Isaac, Haza, Wilun, Odell, Jermaine, Charlene. You guys are the best amongst the thousands that took part this season. I am not sure if you realize what that means, but the best way is for you to show that appreciation through your performance. Based on last week's performances, the highest ranked contestant is...
Very likable, according to Jacqueline. But she also said this person needs to be a little bit more adventurous in his or her performance.
Can we have... Isaac?
My name is Isaac. I love singing. Singing's my passion, and I'm giving myself a shot at this because I just want to really bring hope and love through music. What do you feel is one of the most important things to be able to sustain this industry?
It's a lot of work. It's a lot of time not spent with loved ones, friends. For the industry as a whole, I hope we can find ways to advertise who Isaac Ong is. Nobody's going to do it for you. You have to do it. Isaac seems to sing behind a facade. He has to learn to break through that, to leave himself open, raw, which is the essence of a good singer.
Second highest ranking contestant. This person has been very consistent and also very driven. Can we have Charlene on stage?
Hi, my name is Charlene. Nice to meet you. And I joined the final one because I really want to sing. Like, and I want to make what I love into a career.
I noticed when you were singing, you were swallowing your words a little bit.
Yeah.
You have to be clear. Every word has to be...
enunciated. Yes.
Singers, musicians will always be exploited. I'm telling you the bad side of the industry.
Yes, I understand.
Okay? So you have to read between the lines, the fine print and all that, and never take anything for granted. That's the industry. Give yourself a...
image.
An image that someone that will, people will identify with. 10 years or so, you have to reinvent yourself. You're not going to stay like this forever.
She's intelligent, so that goes a long way. She has the ability to differentiate between all these styles, so I hope she can find her way to pull elements from all these things to set up her own style. And with that, she can go very far.
But just because a record has a groove, don't make it in the groove. And you can tell right away at letter A when the people start to move.
Hi, Zach. Hi, Charlene.
Hello.
I think you guys did a pretty good job. You got some moves on stage just now, but I think you should let loose a bit more. Isaac, it was a fun song, but you look a bit too serious. Yeah, you should smile a bit more. You should let loose a lot more. You have that stage presence. All you need to do is just brush up on a few things on your vocals, and I think you're good to go. Charlene. Stevie Wonder, that's not an easy song.
It's not.
Yeah, any song on Stevie Wonder is not easy. I think you did a fairly good job. It lacked the punch for the song. I think it was a bit too sweet for me. Maybe that song might not have helped you as I think you want it to. Besides that, I think you have a beautiful voice. Keep working at it, and that was a pretty good job. Well done. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Just before the break, we had Isaac and Charlene perform for us. It's starting to become a little bit familiar, this scene, the two of you all, in the top two.
Isaac, how do you feel about your performance?
I thought it was good. I'm still trying to like have more fun and just relax and enjoy, and I'm glad for the feedback that Taufik gave. So I'm just going to keep working on that and just keep pushing myself harder.
Yeah. All right. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
And Charlene, Taufik said that for this song, you need to have a little bit more grit in your voice. What do you think about that?
Well, fast songs are usually outside of my comfort zone, and I was really trying to groove, and I can't really do like Isaac, you know, like he's really dancing and walking, and I have heels, and that's not possible for me. But I was really trying my best, and this is one of my favorite songs, so I was trying to do justice to it.
That's great to hear. Well, over to you, judges.
Kid, you have been in the business so long. What advice would you provide to our contestants?
Everyone with talent will get noticed at the beginning, but to really last, I think character is the defining thing. When you're a newbie, first 5 years, that's like the first phase where you're just trying to understand what's going on. And then after that, when you're no longer the newbie, the next phase is how do you sustain people's interest in you, and how do you continue to grow as an artist?
It's a constant struggle. I've only been in the industry for 12 years. I mean, not as long as you guys.
He says only, yeah. You notice that?
No, but yeah. I'm still learning, because to stay relevant in this industry right now, it's even harder because there's stars born every other day.
Eventually, it's a question of how hard you're willing to work and really persevere.
So I was told that the judges have very high expectations of this next performer. I'd like to hear it for myself. Can we have Jermaine?
Hi, I'm Jermaine Leong. This year I'm 17. To me, singing is my first love and it's my passion, and I want to do this for the rest of my life, which is why I joined the competition.
Do you want to turn it into a career?
Yes.
You realize there's a lot of sacrifices you have to make. At least you're going in with your eyes open. Study people's styles and take some from here, take some from here, cut and paste, cut and paste, cut and paste, and develop your own.
How have you been able to sustain yourself for so long?
With a lot of difficulty. Discipline, reinvention. She has the drive, she has the yearning, but she has to put in, like everybody else, a lot of work. She's lucky because age is on her side.
This individual is someone that has a very nice tone, but at times pretty dazed.
Wow. Okay. I'd like to call Odell.
Everybody's got a thing, but some...
I watched you singing just now.
Yes.
What do you think?
It wasn't that good.
Who says?
I think so.
No, why? You are your own worst critic, is it? Why do you want to be in the industry?
Since young, I've always dreamed of being an artist. And I guess to make my dream come true, it would be trying to develop myself and growing in this industry. Don't you worry about a thing.
Is that falsetto or real voice?
Falsetto.
Real voice?
Don't you worry about a thing.
So much better. Because you project better.
Voice projection is important. Stage projection is just as important.
When you're singing in a competition like this, right? Mm-hmm. You got a lot of people telling you, oh, you're pitchy. Oh, you're... Can you handle all that?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not trying to scare you off the industry, but the industry is a mean one, just like any other industry. The industry is like a eat you up and spit you out kind of industry, okay? You have to be really strong to survive.
Everybody's got a thing, but some don't know how to handle it. Always bridge.
reaching out in vain. Sick than the things not worth having. Don't you worry about a thing.
Jermaine, how did you feel about that? What you did? You happy with it?
Yes.
Okay, good. You know,
sorry.
That's good. It's always good to be confident. You know what I liked about you was you had great feel. You either have it or you don't. And you have this ability to take us into your song. I like that. And even though it wasn't technically perfect, it didn't really matter to me because I was just sucked into that. But I think you need a lot of work on your showmanship. There's one thing I'd like to say. Whenever you use anything on stage, only use it if it helps your performance. I'm not sure what the mic stand did for you. You weren't interacting with it and it just became distracting. So think about that the next time you want to use something on stage. Yeah, but otherwise, very nice.
Hey,
very
thank you.
Nice. Odell?
Hello.
I agree with Ken. You have great tone. I mean, the moment you open your mouth, it's like, whoa, thank nice.
You.
Nice tone. And you're very confident on stage, obviously. Where you move, your facial expression is all very attractive and appealing. But again, the same thing as Jermaine was, what was that? That dead air as you strut down, you took at least 5 steps before you got there. So to me, that was dead air. So again, think about why are you doing that? Does it add to your performance or does it actually take away? Otherwise, great.
Thank you so much.
I enjoyed it.
We have 2 contestants left and only one will get to sing. So it's getting really tense in the studio right now. But before that, we have a special guest performance right after these messages.
Despite leaving the competition last season, these season 1 final 1 contestants have proven that it's never the end of the road.
I made it to the top 10 in the first season of the final 1 and I got voted out when there were about 8 people left in the competition.
Yuresh, you will be going home tonight.
The final 1 really opened lots of doors for me. I met my bandmate Glenn in the competition. So right after the final 1, me and Glenn formed a band called Still Sunrise. Ever since then, we started playing lots of shows and we really started to connect musically. It was really through the final 1 that we really got accepted into the music community and accepted for being musicians. See how I
live with every piece of... Final 1 was one of, in fact, the main first commercial singing competition that I participated. And the journey was really indeed a very well experienced. After the final 1, I didn't stop singing. In fact, I be more active in music. I started to do like covers. And my first cover, a song by one of the Indonesian band, then that song was nominated for Anugerah Planet Music. Then along the way, I was sort of offered to join SG Mania, one of the biggest Mediacorp Suria singing competition. I feel really blessed, like what's going on for the past like 2 years. So I'm really like happy of where am I am and the future projects that I'm having.
During the final 1, I made it to top 8. It was from final 1 that I managed to realize that it's not because of a competition that defines who you are, but you know, it's what you do after that. So I'm proud of where I am right now, thanks to the final one. After the final one, I've been doing a lot of teaching, a lot of gigging, and I have a single out, Frankenstein. Now I'm working on my EP. Yeah, I'm just hoping to release it later this year. Final one has helped me to make me realize that, you know, I have to be very comfortable on stage because I'm a frontman. That would definitely be the biggest takeaway for me. Just glad that happened.
Some call him the legend. Others call him a guitar hero. Please welcome Zul Sultan, performing with this season's finalists, Haitian, Shanice, and Bernard.
If I could reach the stars, pull one down for you, shining on my heart, so you can see the truth.
Zul, first of all, welcome to the final one.
Thank you.
We'd just like to say thanks, you know, for spending some time with some of the contestants here. How was it working with some of our contestants?
I don't know, the pleasure was all mine.
Yeah.
And it was very refreshing because to see so many young talents with the passion. You found your craft, hone it. Practice.
Some very wise words for a veteran in the music industry. So, how about you guys, Haitian and Shanice? What was it like working with Zul?
It was a great privilege, really, because to have someone like Zul to coach us, and he was very patient with us, with all our parts, and so we're very thankful to him. Yes, you were. Yeah, thank you so much.
To work with a veteran who can guide us and, like, give us tips about the industry and to tell us things about
how to become a better performer. Really is a privilege. We never get the opportunity to meet people like him, so.
All right, that's nice to know. Hope you guys had a lot of things to learn. So now, we have to get down to business. We have Weilun and Aza left on the stand. Bernard, who do you think will make it through tonight?
Wow, Sean, you're really putting me on the spot. You know, being in the top 10, we've formed a great bond. So seeing both of them there, it really kills, because I don't want any of them to go back home. So I really don't know. They're both amazing.
All right, awesome. Give him a round of applause. So let's find out who gets to sing next after this break.
My lover's got humor. She's the giggle at a funeral. Knows everybody's disapproval. I should have worshipped her sooner.
What happens if I leave the show now? I should be really grateful for where I am right now, being the final six. Most memorable, I guess it will be the episode where I'm in the bottom two with Gareth.
The last contestant to qualify will be Weilun.
It was so emotional because it's quite a disappointment for myself. I felt that I can do a lot better. I've learned that hard work is very important. You know, no matter how talented you are, but if you don't put in the hard work, you don't put in the time to, like, you know, try to do it well, you will never succeed, you know?
It's time to make a start.
If I leave the show now, I'll definitely keep doing what I do best. I'll not give up. I'll try to find ways to put myself out there. I will miss singing on stage. Being in front of hundreds of people, showcase my talent. I have learned a lot, not just the judges, from the contestants, producers, they guide me through everything. Everyone treat me really good.
It's nerve-wracking right now to be on stage. No matter what happens after this, you've done a great job. Continue to work on your craft and just don't stop. Weilun, you seem to somehow perform better under pressure. But despite having an interesting tone to your voice, you've been a little erratic in the past few performances, and we are not sure whether the competition can wait for you. Aza, I've always said that you have a unique, rich tone to your voice. And you came out of your shell last week for your performance, so that's good. But the judges are not sure whether that performance was just a one-off thing. And if you're really ready to give us more, should you go through?
Azahar, you're good looking, you can sing, but yet you're not confident. You need to sort that out. Weilun, consistency is important. You're just too unpredictable. Now, having said that, somebody will have to go home. And it's unfortunate because as the competition comes closer towards the grand finals, obviously we are expecting higher standards. After tabulating the judges' scores, both of you had a tie. So you're going to be given a chance to perform your song. After which, we will have an open vote to decide who goes home. Treasure your opportunity and do well.
Can we have Aza first on stage?
Would you consider making singing a career?
Yes.
Have you thought seriously about it?
Yes, put my heart and soul into it. The judges have told me I'm shy. So how do I overcome it?
You have to learn to look at people and make eye contact. Because what you are doing now, singing is one thing, you know. You are telling me a story. I have to believe you. How do you make me believe you? You have to be able to look at 1,000 people and say, hey, hello. And not be afraid. Connect to people. Tell them your story, make them believe your story. Potential is there, but Asa's a very shy person. He has to break that when he's on stage, he has to throw away that shyness and then perform.
Would you know my name if I saw you in heaven? Would it be the same if I saw you in heaven? I must be strong. Carry on, 'cause I know I don't belong here in heaven. Time can bring you down, time can bend your knees, time can break your heart.
All right, Waylon, you've seen and heard what Azhar did. Do your best, don't be nervous, and give it all you got. All right, good luck.
Have you always liked singing?
Oh, I've been singing since I was young. I love singing, you know, and along the years goes by, I pick up the guitar to accompany my singing, you know. And all this while, I've been playing music in my bedroom, so I thought I would take it out of the bedroom, you know, and bring it to the stage. I'm joining this competition to, you know, step out of my comfort zone.
This is a process to get yourself known to the public that will prop you up for the industry, the experience. My impression of Waylon is he's a rocking guy. He's ever ready to go. He wants to sing. He loves to sing. He has all the confidence, and confidence is really all you need.
So cold and I long for your Thank you.
With both Azha and Weilun in the bottom this week, one will stay and one must go. Whittling down the competition to the final five, the judges make their toughest decision yet.
Each time I have to ask myself who deserves to go on to the next round, I will always try and identify the qualities in the performance. As far as vocal delivery is concerned, I thought both of you did equally well. In terms of having a more creative performance, Weilun did a better job. So my vote goes to Weilun.
This is really tough. The judges are quite divided with our decision. It's two very different performances, but there was one particular performance that gave me goosebumps. I connected with that performance more. So having said that, my vote goes to Azha.
The difficult decision now lies with me, yeah? Weilun, you had something. I mean, I saw the potential in you. You were creative, like Ken said, and you had this X factor that... But you see, the problem was that you showed me what you might be able to do. But once again, I mean, I wasn't here in your earlier performances, but I was told that you were like up and down and you were unpredictable. So I think that would be the biggest stumbling block for you, is how can you deliver every time? I saw the potential, but I need to be convinced further. Azha, you were very, very good with your vocal delivery and it was moving. You were very intense. But again, your problem is that you are still very trapped within yourself. It would be so much nicer to see you come out. So, if I have to vote, I'll go with something that moved me today. And that's Azha.
And just like that, we say goodbye to Weilun. And hello to our final five.
Next week on, you'll be performing two songs per week. It's going to be a lot tougher. I suspect that the final one would be someone that really wants to win. Because each and every one of you, I think you're special. It's a little bit difficult to actually assess who is better vocally, but it's easy to tell who wants it more.
I think when Ken says who wants it more, it's not about saying, oh, I'm so ambitious and I want it. It's about that inner strength that we're looking for. And I know it's tough, but please just believe in yourself and just only think about the stage. Like, forget about how you feel. You're gonna be fine.
The five of you, you're all very talented. It's just gonna boil down to who wants it more. You guys are really good. You deserve to be on stage. And for this next episode, the one that's gonna leave the show will be the one who probably practiced lesser, or who didn't work hard enough, or who's not focused. So just keep working on your craft, yeah?
You are the top five. That itself, it's a recognition. It's priceless. Treasure that.
I'm sorry to say that, you know, this is the end of the journey for you. What's running through your mind now?
Well, it's a competition, so I'm definitely disappointed that I got eliminated. I'm just really grateful to be a part of this competition because it brought me to another level of my own musicality. I just became a more confident person. I'm so grateful for everything I received from this competition. My friends, you know, the comments the judges gave. They're all my friends. And I'm really happy for Azha. He's one of my best buddies. I'm just excited for my own future, you know. Like, now that I have this experience, you know, I don't know what's more exciting will come for me, you know, in the music industry.
And it's always sad, you know, to see buddies go home, but I suppose, you know, that's the way that the competition goes. So, tune in next week to find out how this story unfolds, only here on The Final One. I'm Sean Jensen, and good night. Yeah, they were dancing and singing.